And now we will learn about held checks and undeposited funds. We all know that sometimes we get paid by check. And of course, there's usually a big time difference between the day we get paid by the check and the day that we physically deposit the money into the bank. Now, up until now, we have been recording transactions that get directly deposited into the bank. But if we get paid by check on one day and we don't deposit the money for 2 weeks, what do we reflect in our accounting records during those 2 weeks? Remember, our records have to show the fact that the customer does not owe the money during those 2 weeks. During those 2 weeks, our records should reflect the fact that we physically have the money. But we can't record it in the way that we recorded it in earlier videos because the money was not put directly into the bank. So what do we do? Well, what happens when we get money? If we get money from a customer who previously owed us money, both accounts receivable in the chart of accounts and that particular customer's balance goes down. And in previous videos, we recorded the money into cash in bank because that's what happened in that example. But if the money did not go into cash in bank at the moment we physically were handed a check, which account do we record the money going into? Well, that's the reason why we have this special account called undeposited funds. Undeposited funds is the account that represents the money received from customers that is expected to be deposited into the bank. It is a current asset, and its detailed type is undeposited funds. And this is the first time we're adding an account to the chart of accounts where we have to be mindful of the detail type to get it to behave the way we need to. Making the detail type undeposited funds is what tells QuickBooks that this is an account that is connected to the deposit window in a special way. It allows us to keep track of each check or bit of cash and credit card swipes that we received but has not yet been deposited into the bank. Now, undeposited funds was not placed in our chart of accounts automatically by QuickBooks when we created the account. We will have to put it ourselves. Click Accounting, then click Chart of Accounts, then we can come over to the right and click New. Now, the type of account should be other current asset. That allows you to choose the detail type undeposited funds. You'll have to click the detail type here and scroll down and come down to undeposited funds, the very last choice. You could change the name to money waiting to be deposited or money we received. For, you know, you can put any name you want, but the best name is really undeposited funds because it's well known that this is money we expect to deposit into the bank. We click Save and Close, and now we have undeposited funds in our chart of accounts and we can use it. Now let's review receiving money. Let's imagine on February 23rd, we did 10 editing hours for Candy, and she paid us a check for that. Well, if we got paid right away, whether it's check, direct deposit, cash, or whatever, we still have to record a sales receipt. But before we record a sales receipt, let's discuss what the results will be this time. Editing income becomes what number? Well, if we take a look at our trial balance right now, custom reports, my trial balance, we can see that editing income, here it is, editing income before this transaction is $17,960. But we just earned more editing income, $1,400 worth, so editing income will become $19,360. undeposited funds is going to show up for the very first time as $1,400 because this is the first payment in our hand of $1,400. So let's go ahead and make the sale receipt exactly the way we learned before. In the top right, we click the plus sign. We go over to the left and click sales receipt. Now the first thing you have to do is make sure the date is all the way back at February 23rd. Then we choose the proper customer, in this case it's Candy. And of course, what service did we provide for Candy? We provided, in this case, the editing service. QuickBooks remembers it's $140 an hour, so if we did 10 of these, the sales receipt is in the amount of $1,400. Now, the only difference between the previous examples and the one we're doing now is, first, we have to make sure that this money gets deposited into undeposited funds. Now, why is it going into undeposited funds for this one, but in the previous ones we chose cash and bank? That's because this time the payment method, which we'll click for the pull down, the payment method is check. And if you choose payment method check, then QuickBooks knows that the reference number is actually the customer's check number that you received. So these three fields are the only fields that will be different if you receive the check compared to the way we got paid before through direct deposit. When we click save, we'll check to make sure that the numbers in the trial balance are exactly as what we expected. When we come back, we see that editing income shows up as $19,360, which is the amount we expected, and the $1,400 should appear for the first time in undeposited funds. Here's undeposited funds showing up in the trial balance for the first time as $1,400. Now let's do a second example from the other transaction where we learned how to receive money from customers. Let's imagine on February 24th, we received $1,000 cash in our hand from Betty for payment of the oldest open unpaid invoices. Well, what will be the result if we receive $1,000 cash? Well, right now, accounts receivable is $24,440, but it will go down by $1,000 if we actually get paid. So accounts receivable should become $23,440. Now, we know the money has to go into undeposited funds because it is in our hand and not in the bank. But what will it become? Well, if undeposited funds is only $1,400 before that transaction, then if we get another $1,000 in our hand, undeposited funds should become $2,400. Let's go ahead and record receiving this payment. We click the plus sign, then we click receive payment just like we learned before. Don't forget to advance the date to the 24th, the date of this transaction. The customer in this case was Betty, so we're going to choose Betty. And of course, we see Betty's open invoices appear here. Very important, you make sure that you are not depositing the money into the bank account like the previous examples. Very important that you choose undeposited funds because we got the money in our hand. In this case, the payment method is cash. Cash. So that tells a person why there is no reference number. Maybe we didn't write a handwritten receipt, we just took the cash and said thank you. So the amount we received is $1,000, and if we push the tab key, QuickBooks assumes that we're applying the money to the oldest invoice if there's no matching invoice for the money amount. So we agree with everything we put into the fields of this window. Now when we click save and close, let's see if the numbers in the trial balance are what we expected them to be. Well, accounts receivable decreased to $23,440, which is the amount we predicted, and undeposited funds should be $2,400. If we come up here, undeposited funds, $2,400. So the numbers are exactly as what we expected. Now let's pause the video for you to enter these two on your own. You'll know how to do them from the other two, but we need a little bit more in undeposited funds before we can actually practice making a deposit. Now these are what your results are supposed to look like. When you finish the other two, cash and bank should be $20,370 and undeposited funds should be $10,400 and accounts receivable should be $21,440. Editing income should be $19,360 and video income should be $47,700. So make sure you have the same numbers that I have, and you should if you did the sale receipt and payment correctly. Now let's talk about what happens when you physically deposit the money. Undeposited funds will go down because you have less undeposited because you just made a deposit. Of course, cash and bank will go up because you just put some money into the bank. For example, let's imagine we will deposit the February 27th, let's imagine that on February 27th, we deposit check number 1717 from Candy back from February 23rd when we received that check, and the $1,000 in cash from Betty that we received on the 24th. Let's predict what undeposited funds will become. Well, right now undeposited funds is $10,400, but if the amount that we're actually depositing is $2,400, undeposited funds should become $8,000. Let's predict what cash and bank becomes. Well, if cash and bank is going to increase by $2,400, that means that cash and bank will become $22,700. So let's take a look at how to make the deposit. From the plus sign in the top right, we click Bank Deposit. Now notice it's the same window we went to before, but the reason it looks different is because all of the money in undeposited funds automatically shows up here. If you notice, you can scroll down and get a section of this window that looked exactly the same way that it looked before we had undeposited funds. So you could still deposit the individual payments in the same deposit as the other things and give the cash back the way we learned in the previous videos when we made a deposit. So the bottom part stays the same, but the top part is listing the items that are in undeposited funds. Now the instructions clearly said the check number 171 from the 23rd and the $1,000 in cash from the 24th. So check number 17, the money we received on the 23rd, which is reference number 1717, we'll place a check mark in that, and QuickBooks tries to calculate the deposit. What about the $1,000 in cash that we received on the 24th? Click the check mark in the left margin there. So now we see if we're depositing physically these two items, we know that the total of this deposit is $2,400. Don't forget the date that we're physically depositing the money is here, February 27. So we have to make sure the date in the top right, we bring it back to February 27. Now it has all the information we need. Make sure we're depositing it into Chase Bank. And here we go. When we click Save and Close, we now check if the results in the trial balance are what we expect. Cash in bank, $22,770. Well, we predicted cash in bank would be $22,770. Is undeposited funds $8,000? Undeposited funds $8,000. So that means we did it correctly. Now on February 28th, let's deposit the remainder of undeposited funds just for good measure and see if you get the same numbers that I get. Let's do this. The plus sign, go to bank deposit, advance the date to the 28th. Now for depositing the remaining money in undeposited funds, we click the check mark on everything. Don't forget the date is the 28th. It's going into cash and bank. That's it. You don't have to use the bottom section because there's no cash back for expenses. We click save and close. And now when you finish this video, your cash in bank should be $30,770 and your undeposited funds should be zero because we deposited all the money.